anime begins with two criminals escaping. While one is tampering with an elevator, other one keeps watch. Suddenly the person keeping watch perishes to a gunshot. The criminal with him escapes via the elevator. He glances at the man known as Fable who shot his comrade. The man exits the elevator and gets shot by Fable. Despite having two allies at the scene to provide him with backup, Fable successfully defeats them. Before the man dies, he asks Fable if he's Fable. Fable says it's a simple title his victims gave him and ends the man's life. Fable meets with his female comrade and informs her about his recent experience. He tells her to turn on the car's television. Fable laughs at the comedy on display and the woman's baffled he's laughing after murdering people. Fable tells her to focus on getting him to the dock. The two visit boss's base at the dock. The boss confronts Fable about his past targets and the business they've been running. He tells Fable he won't provide him with work since they did too much this year. Boss gives Fable and his female comrade the money they've earned. Moreover, he promises to get driver's licenses and insurance cards made for Fable, his female friend, and himself. He says they'll head to Osaka since he knows a Yakuza group that can assist them. Fable's unsure about this, but the boss suggests Fable should experience what life feels like in an unfamiliar environment. However, his boss says if he or his female friend murder anyone, he'll kill both of them. Fable and his female comrade return to his base. While Fable's gathering his belongings, his female ally tells him how things will go when they arrive in Osaka. She shows Fable his fake ID, informing him of the name his boss entrusted him with. Also, she tells Fable what name she'll be going by from this point forward. Her name is Yoko Sato and she'll act as Fable's sister. On the Shinmation Expressway, Yoko asks Fable what encouraged him to become a hitman. Fable questions Yoko about calling him brother. Yoko says they must adjust to referring to each other like this. Then the two arrive at a rest stop. Fable spots several car thieves nearby and Yoko warns Fable not to cause trouble. He asks Yoko to purchase a drink for him after she finishes using the rest stop's restroom. Fable rests at a nearby bench and monitors their car and the thieves. The two thieves wander toward Fable and Fable gets up. He tells the thieves he doesn't want trouble, but they ask him to take his wallet out. Before he seemingly does, Fable hurts them. Yoko arrives and yelps. She yells at Fable for harming the thieves, but Fable says it is out of instinct and self-defense. The two head to their car and drive away from the rest stop. Yoko yells at Fable for his actions. Fable feels that living an ordinary lifestyle might be more challenging than anticipated. Later, Yoko asks Fable if he knows the Kansai dialect. Fable says he's mastered it and four others. He says he can switch between dialects easily. Once they arrive in a city, the two discuss the Meguro group. Yoko says they're the only Yakuza in Aseicho, Tahiai, Osaka, and shares details regarding its higher-ups. She says the Meguro group's boss Hiroshi and their captain Takashi are the only ones who know of their situation. The two stop somewhere and Yoko's unamused by Fable's dialect switching method. As soon as they exit their vehicle, Fable starts rambling in the dialect, impressing Yoko. The two visit a nearby shop because Yoko wants Fable to get a tire to impress the folks they plan to meet. We cut away to the Meguro group's headquarters. A man named Takashi chats with Hiroshi about Fable. He's unsure if they should harbor him, while Hiroshi partially agrees with Takashi, ensures him that everything will be okay. However, he finds Fable's past activities intriguing and baffling. Hiroshi informs Takashi about Fable's run-in with the same Ken group. He says Fable successfully murdered a group's leader and their men with one shot. Suddenly, one of Hiroshi's men enters the room, informing him that Sato aka Fable has arrived. Hiroshi tells his henchmen to lead Sato to the reception room while Takashi asks the henchmen not to let anyone else in for a while. Fable and Yoko enter the reception room and speak with Takashi and Hiroshi. Takashi asks Fable to tell him how he'd murder him and Hiroshi if we were given orders to do so. He wants to see if Fable is truly a genius killer. Fable lists several methods and tools he'd use to perform the deed. He mentions Takashi's gun and Takashi reveals it to everyone's dismay. Takashi knows he's not allowed to bring firearms into the office. Yet he tells Hiroshi he didn't want to attend this meeting unarmed, especially with Fable around. Takashi asks Fable how he'd kill the 10 men outside with his gun since it's only carrying 5 bullets. Fable says he'd use Hiroshi's firearm instead. Hiroshi laughs and reveals his firearm to everyone. Fable doesn't share details on how he knew they were carrying weapons. Nonetheless, Hiroshi ensures Fable and Yoko can crash at the place they're offering them for a year. Takashi says he and Hiroshi are the only ones who know their true identities. Moreover, he highlights the rules that Fable and Yoko must comply with. Then Takashi leads Yoko and Fable to their homes. He briefs them on what he and his men used them for in the past. After Takashi leads the two into the home's garage, he hands Fable a revolver. He wants to see Fable's superb marksmanship in action. Fable shoots a different target and gets debris over Takashi's beloved car. Yoko comforts Takashi, telling him she'll clean up the mess. Takashi leaves and regroups with his ally. He and his ally touch upon Yoko and Fable's distinct skills. Then Takashi tells his ally to watch Yoko and Fable for him. Meanwhile, Fable investigates his home and dismantles every camera he can find. Later, Takashi regroups with his ally. His ally informs him the cameras in Fable's room aren't functioning. However, he says Yoko's home's cameras are intact. Takashi reveals that he wants to chase Yoko and Fable out of the city. While Hiroshi's seemingly okay with them being here, Takashi's not. Nonetheless, Takashi tells his ally to do what he can. Later, Fable and Yoko attend a bar. While those two enjoy themselves, Takashi's ally monitors the bar from his vehicle and calls one of his allies, asking for a skilled combatant. Fable's acting uneasy in the bar, and Yoko questions him about his demeanor, suggesting he find a new hobby and relax during his vacation. Fable is unsure about that notion and asks Yoko about her hobbies. Yoko says she wants to net herself a hot boyfriend. Then we cut away to Takashi's ally Takahashi. Another member of their group arrives with a professional kickboxer. Takahashi asks the kickboxer to severely wound Fable. Fable and Yoko exit the bar and encounter the kickboxer and Takahashi's ally. Fable tells Yoko to go home and let him handle these goons. Yoko leaves and Fable battles the kickboxer and his ally. He develops and utilizes multiple fakeouts and clever tactics during this battle. The two men flee the fight after dealing enough damage to Fable. Then, a girl arrives and gives Fable a handkerchief to wipe his nose. Fable notices this is the same girl he saw earlier after he finished his camera disabling activity. We cut away to Takahashi the kickboxer and his ally. They discuss payment and the kickboxer and his ally's encounter with Fable. Then we follow Fable, who grabs himself a drink from a nearby machine, saying that Osaka is a fun place. Takashi and Takahashi chatting on a phone. Takahashi informs Takashi about what he and the others did to Fable. He ensures Takashi that they didn't harm Yoko though. Then a black market arms dealer named Matsu graces Takashi's presence. He passes Takashi some .38 caliber rounds. Then we cut to Fable in his home. He's watching his favorite comedian Jackal on television. Then he receives several texts from his boss that he can't decipher. This entices Fable to check in with Yoko. Fable hands Yoko his phone and asks her what their boss is alluding to. Yoko tells Fable that the boss wants him to get an actual pet. The two visit a market called Lashin. Then the two examine a few pets and Yoko questions why their boss wants them to get pets. Fable notices a nearby bird reminding him of a bird emblem on one of his favorite firearms. He tells Yoko that he wants this bird. Then Fable notices the guy who was hanging around the kickboxer and Takahashi from the previous night. He leaves Yoko alone with the birds. Fable gets this gentleman's attention and leads him somewhere. The two men charge at Fable. Fable notices them and ponders how he should handle this situation. Eventually, Fable leaps off a bridge and successfully lands on his feet. Fable flees and this frustrates the kickboxer. He regroups with Yoko at Lashin minutes later. Yoko tells Fable she's getting a hamster and that the black-headed parrot he wants is 190,000 yen. And Fable returned to Fable's place, specifically his place's garage. Before Fable departs, Yoko reminds him to develop a name for the bird. She plans to think of one for her hamster. Fable tells the bird where his food and drinks are located. Also, he names his pet as Captain. Then we cut to Takashi and Takahashi chatting in their car. Takahashi informs Takashi about Fable's incredible athleticism. Takashi suggests Takahashi ask Yoko out to dinner. He offers Takahashi cash in exchange for interrogating Yoko and retrieving intel about Fable from her. Then we receive a scene of Yoko bonding with her hamster. Meanwhile, we see Fable exercising in the garage. Takashi arrives, reminding Fable that the garage is off limits, unlike the second floor. Also, he's flustered that Fable's exercising without clothes on. While Takashi starts his car, he tells Fable he wants to chat with him alone tonight at 9 p.m. Fable complies and Takashi tells him to get ready for it. Then we see Takahashi visiting Yoko at her place. Yoko welcomes Takahashi inside. Inside, Takahashi tells Yoko that Takashi wants him to show her around town. Yoko accepts Takahashi's offer and informs Fable about their exchange later via cell phone. Fable tells Yoko to have fun and Yoko tells Fable not to kill anyone while he's hanging out with Takashi. Later, Fable regroups with Takashi in his vehicle. Takashi drives to an undisclosed location and hands Fable a tight-knit cap. He wants Fable to prove that he's the real hitman Fable. The two drive up to a large man. Takashi says he wants Fable to fight that man because he did his boss wrong. Fable questions if he should fight this man because his boss specifically said not to cause problems. The person he must fight questions if the deal he made with Takashi remains intact. Another man says it will as long as he beats up Fable until he's near death or is dead. Fable puts his mask on and Takashi promises to clean up the mess. Fable exits the vehicle and his opponent scolds him for his appearance. Fable confronting his target, Fable knocks the man out in 6 seconds and tells Takashi's accomplice to do as he pleases with this target. Takashi exits his vehicle, points his gun at Fable, and orders him to kill the target. Then Fable knocks out the other person in the area. Fable steals that individual's gun and directs it at Takashi. He orders Takashi to put his gun down. Takashi walks up to Fable, directs his gun at Fable's face, and compares him to other serial killers he knows about. Fable says he's not like other killers. Also, Fable says he'd like to live a peaceful life in this neighborhood. Fable drops his weapon, removes his mask, and bows before Takashi. He pleads with Takashi to let him live in this town. After hearing Fable out, Takashi directs his gun at the man Fable defeated. Takashi murders the man and explains why he murdered him to Fable. Then Takashi informs his ally Kuro that Fable will be staying with them in Taihei for a year. Takashi tells Kuro to keep everything that happened here a secret. Meanwhile, Takahashi and Yoko visit a bar and Takahashi questions how much this date will cost him. Yoko asks Takahashi if she can get some alcohol. Takahashi complies and says he'll drink alongside her. At the eatery, Takashi and Fable discuss the cameras Fable removed in his room. Fable says he didn't want to remove Yoko's cameras because of safety reasons. Then Fable questions Takashi, asking him why he wanted to test him as soon as he did. Fable argues it had been in Takashi's best interest to observe him for 2 weeks before doing so. Takashi says he wanted to get rid of his concerns with Fable. Takashi tells Fable that he doesn't 100% trust him yet but doesn't mind him or Yoko living in Taihei. Fable promises Takashi that he wants to live here peacefully. Also, he mentions that Yoko insisted that he pursue a hobby in Taihei. Takashi says Fable should consider applying for a job somewhere. Then we return to following Yoko and Takashi. The two arrive at Yoko's home and Yoko makes a fool out of Takahashi while they're there. Next, we spot Takashi and Fable driving somewhere. The two spot the woman who handed Fable the handkerchief before. Takashi reveals her name's Misaki and that she's working 5 jobs. He says Misaki wants to pay her family's debt and open a store. Takashi tells Fable not to get involved with Misaki. Takashi drops Fable off at his current residence. Takashi meets with Kuro. Kuro tells Takashi that Hiroshi wants to speak with him in his office. Hiroshi knows what Takashi did with Fable. Takashi apologizes for his actions and states that he wanted to test Fable. Hiroshi laughs and tells Takashi that Fable's organization may have others like him. Moreover, Hiroshi says if Takashi had shot Fable, Fable's organization would have come for Takashi, Hiroshi, and Kuro. Hiroshi hopes things will go well for Takashi and his brother Kojima. Meanwhile, Takahashi apologizes to Yoko for staying the night and Takahashi departs. Later, Takahashi meets with Takashi. Takahashi apologizes for getting drunk on the date and promises to gather intel on Fable next time. Next, Takahashi and Kuro visit the bridge Fable jumped off previously. Kuro knows who Fable is but doesn't want to tell Takahashi. Regardless, Kuro's excited that Fable is the real deal and leaps off the same bridge. Then Takahashi informs Takashi about Kuro's ridiculous stunt. Takashi arrives at the hospital to greet Takahashi and Kuro. Takashi takes Kuro somewhere and interrogates him. He questions if Kuro pulled that stunt because Kuro wants to become a hitman like Fable. Takashi grabs Kuro's face and explains why he should abandon his desire to act like Fable. Meanwhile, Fable fills out a resume form in his room and attends an interview. Unfortunately, the interviewer doesn't find Fable's responses great, so Fable leaves to complete another interview elsewhere. This new interview doesn't go well either. Eventually, Misaki bumps into Fable and notices he's holding a resume in his hands. She says her workplace would gladly accept him. Fable and Misaki visit her boss at her workplace. Misaki convinces her boss to interview Fable. Misaki's boss goes over Fable's resume with him. He says if Fable can perform other duties besides delivery work, he'll think about offering Fable a raise. Misaki hands Fable tea and Fable tells her boss that he'll accept the position. Next, Fable calls Takashi and informs him about his new delivery job at Misaki's workplace. Takashi's upset that Fable interacted with Misaki. Takashi tells Fable he'll get him a new job and demands that he quit the job at Misaki's workplace. Fable refuses and ends the call. Later, he visits Yoko and tells her about his new job. Yoko's baffled that Fable would accept a job with a low pay rate. Additionally, we learn Yoko named her hamster as Hei. Next, Yoko brings up the idea of Fable falling in love with Misaki. Fable's unsure about that, however he says he doesn't mind trying to fall in love with Misaki. Later, Fable arrives at his workplace early, shocking his boss. Elsewhere, Takashi visits Kojima, and Kojima telling Takashi that he can't wait to cut loose. Misaki's boss showing Fable the Porsches they use for their deliveries. Misaki's boss ensures Fable it won't take him long to reach his destination despite Fable looking slightly disappointed. Next, Takashi and Kojima visit a restaurant to eat. Fable returns to his workplace. He tells Misaki's boss that he finished his delivery, much to Misaki's boss's surprise. Misaki's boss plans to check with the client to see if Fable successfully delivered the package. He ensures Fable he trusts him, but he wants to ensure the client obtains their delivery. Next, Hiroshi presents Kojima with his payment for his hard work. Later, Takashi tells Kojima to make himself at home, yet he does want Kojima to search for a place to call home. Kojima requests for a gun, but Takashi refuses to get him one. Later, Fable, Misaki, and the others visit a restaurant. Fable and Misaki's boss discuss profits and experience. Then Fable drops something and notices one of his co-workers has a camera between their legs. Fable notices Misaki's wearing a skirt and Misaki tells him that she works at a bar too. Then Fable eats something strange. This spirals into a discussion about Fable's bizarre eating habits and harsh early life experiences. While Misaki tells Fable not to eat his meal bone, the camera-armed gentleman tilts the camera toward Misaki's skirt. Fable notices what Misaki's co-worker's up to and swiftly flicks a chicken bone at the camera to change its direction. Later, Misaki tells the boys she'll be heading to the bar. Her male co-worker insists on walking her to the bar. Then Misaki's co-worker spots Misaki's keys in her bag and convinces her to let him carry her backpack. When the two reach the bar, Misaki's co-worker returns it to her and wishes her the best. When she's away, we learn Misaki's co-worker swiped Misaki's keys somehow. Then Misaki's co-worker enters her home and starts rummaging through her undergarment compartments. He starts performing nefarious things with her attire and hopes to finish his raunchy activities before Misaki returns home. Through this endeavor, her male co-worker learns she is a model and starts snapping photos of her model pictures from a book. Next, we receive a brief flashback detailing Fable's harsh journey as a child in the forest he spoke of. Misaki returns home and calls Fable. She asks him to stop by and help her with her front door. Fable tries opening the door and Misaki tells him that she lost her keys. Although Fable knows he can open this lock in 5 minutes, he tells Misaki that he can't open it. Misaki says she'll call a locksmith even though it'll take them a while to get here. Fable suggests she stay at his place until the locksmith arrives. Misaki isn't sure how to respond, so Fable departs. Then Misaki asks Fable about Yoko and wonders if she can stay with her. Meanwhile, Misaki's co-worker researches Misaki's model work and learns she worked on a nefarious project. Simultaneously, Fable and Misaki visit Yoko's home. Yoko opens the door and Fable belittling Yoko for smelling like booze. Yoko tampering with Misaki's face. Eventually, Yoko falls asleep, and Misaki thanks Fable for letting her stay at her place. Next, Takahashi arrives at Kojima and Takashi's place. Kojima welcomes Takahashi inside and gets to know him more. However, Kojima treats him like dirt because he doesn't like how Takahashi presents himself. Next, the two check on Takashi because he's been in the bathroom for a long time. The two discover Takashi's unconscious body lying next to the toilet. Meanwhile, Fable watches a new drama show starring Jackal. Elsewhere, Kojima stands by Takashi's hospital bed. Kojima informs Takahashi that Takashi may have suffered a heart attack. Kojima visits Hiroshi the following day and tells him what happened to Takashi. Hiroshi promises to visit Takashi when he's available. Takahashi and Kojima visit Fable later. Kojima tells Takahashi to monitor the vehicle. Fable welcomes Kojima inside and Kojima interrogates Fable. Fable arrives at work and Misaki tells him she found her keys. Meanwhile, Kojima visits Takuda at his home. Kojima wants Takuda to sell him a gun, but Takuda says he doesn't sell those anymore. Kojima thinks Takuda's bluffing and says he'll pay more than the market rate for a firearm and won't tell the others about this transaction. Takuda shows Kojima a revolver and Kojima accepts the deal. Kojima ties up his former senior and introduces Takahashi to him. Kojima confirms his senior was a former member of the Meguro group and swindled Kojima in the past. Kojima tells his senior to get him 6 million yen by today, otherwise he'll murder him. Next, Fable returns home and notices Kuros inside. Kuro tells Fable that Takashi lent him a key to the garage. Kuro begs Fable to make him his disciple. Meanwhile, Kojima removes the garment that's covering his senior's mouth. Kojima Sr. says he can't give him the 6 million yen he seeks, however he attempts to offer Kojima other goods and payment in exchange. Kojima shoots his senior and tells Takahashi not to worry about it. Meanwhile, Fable tells Kuro that he's not interested in making disciples. Fable argues if Kuro wants to be a pro, he shouldn't leave a trace of his work behind. Meanwhile, Kojima is aroused by the murder he committed while Takahashi is speechless. Kojima tells Takahashi to cut his senior's hand off. Misaki's co-worker rummaging through Misaki's swimsuit photos at his home, he learns Misaki quit the erotic business because most of her erotica leaked online. Misaki's co-worker plans to enjoy himself with some videos he took of Misaki later. Next, Yoko tells Fable to go with her somewhere. Fable refuses because he wants to watch Jackal's TV drama tonight. After that, Kojima and Takahashi throw Kojima Sr.'s body into an ocean and Kojima tells Takahashi that his senior deserves to perish. After that, we see Fable training at his place's garage. Yoko arrives and informs Fable that Taihei City has a knife shop. Moreover, Yoko tells Fable that Takashi is in the hospital. We cut to Kojima and Takashi at the hospital. Takashi apologizes to Kojima and tells him he may be at the hospital for another month. Takashi tells Kojima to relax and not get into trouble. He promises Kojima that he has a plan set up for him and Kojima promises he won't do anything dumb. Kojima and Kuro visit a restaurant and Kojima asks Kuro to help him start a call girl service. Even though Sunagawa's running one, Kojima tells Kuro it should be fine for him to start a business. Kuro tells Kojima he knows a girl who can rake in profits for him. Meanwhile, Misaki's working on a design at her workplace while Fable's cleaning the floor there. Misaki doesn't like her lion design and asks Fable to draw a similar one. Fable draws a poorly designed lion, but Misaki and her boss think it'll work for their project. Fable draws more things and Misaki's boss likes all the designs. He plans to use them for the project and gives Fable a pay raise. Meanwhile, Kuro insists Kojima hire Misaki as his main call girl. Kojima likes that idea and tells Kuro to talk to Misaki. Also, Kojima wants Takahashi to hire this call girl for the business he's starting. Takahashi hesitates, and Kojima orders him to get 5 call girls by this week's end. Then we see Sunagawa roaming Taihei City. One of his workers informs him that they spotted Kojima doing something nefarious. Misaki arrives home. Kojima's there and informs Misaki about his future call girl service. Misaki refuses Kojima's call girl offer. Kojima uses Misaki's involvement with Kuro and a swift cover-up story to entice Misaki to comply. Misaki's onto Kojima's game and plans to call the police if Kojima doesn't leave. Kojima says he's not afraid of the cops and will take Misaki there himself. Next, Kojima reminds Misaki he's a Yakuza and threatens her to comply. Kojima gives Misaki his phone number so Misaki can call him. If Misaki doesn't call Kojima at a certain interval, Kojima will arrive at one of her workplaces. Next, Sunagawa visits Hiroshi and tells him Kojima's senior perished recently and suspects Kojima killed him. Sunagawa asks Hiroshi to let him interrogate Kojima. If Kojima killed Sangawa's ally, Sunagawa plans to eliminate Kojima. Next, Misaki ponders Kojima's threat at home and discusses Fable's drawings with her boss at work the next day. Misaki tells Fable the clients approved his illustrations and asks him to accompany her to a restaurant later to celebrate. Meanwhile, Misaki and Fable arrive at the restaurant. Fable shares details about his tough forest life experiences. While ordering, Fable receives a text from Takashi. Takashi tells Fable he wants to discuss things with him. Misaki asks Fable more questions about his life and finds him and Yoko somewhat strange. Fable retaliates and says Misaki's been acting weird lately. He tells Misaki he's willing to help her with anything. Misaki tells Fable not to worry about it and the two continue their discussion. Next, Sunagawa and one of his subordinates greet Takahashi somewhere. Sunagawa tells Takahashi he wants to speak with Kojima. He insists Takahashi tell Kojima to call him later. Takahashi complies and Sunagawa and his ally leave. Later, Fable meets with Takashi at the hospital. Takashi tells Fable to monitor Kojima because Takashi has a hunch he's up to something nefarious. Fable says he's not interested, but Takeshi persuades him to accept this mission and explore their group's warehouse for clues. Then Misaki receives a phone call from her co-worker about one of the managers getting assaulted. Next, Fable arrives at the warehouse and investigates. He discovers a clue, flees the warehouse and calls Takeshi. Fable tells Takeshi Kojima's kickstarting a call girl service and informs him that he may have acquired a firearm. Then Kojima orders Takahashi to hand two gangsters cash. We learn Kojima did orchestrate Misaki's manager's assault. Later Takeshi arrives at Fable's home. Takeshi fears Sunagawa and Kojima will try to murder each other. Takeshi says he'd tell Hiroshi, but he knows Hiroshi will execute Kojima. Fable says he's not interested, so Takeshi offers to give Fable his car if Fable helps him stop Kojima. Sunagawa meeting the pro hitman and his middleman. Sunagawa speaking with the hitman he hired. He wants the hitman to exterminate two people and hands him a photo of Kojima. Sunagawa tells the hitman where he and Kojima plan to meet. During this meeting, Sunagawa wants the hitman to shoot Kojima. Meanwhile, Misaki's pervy co-worker snoops through her home and removes a camera he installed in one of her outlets. Meanwhile, two thugs pummel Misaki's boss at night. He was wandering the streets drunk out of his mind. Then Fable infiltrates Takeshi's home and we receive a flashback. In it, Takeshi gave Fable his home's keys and wanted him to retrieve his revolver. Moreover, Takeshi wants Fable to install six cameras Fable removed from Fable's new home. Takahashi tells Kojima Sunagawa's calling and wants to speak with Kojima about something. While Kojima calls Takahashi, Kainuma watches Misaki's home camera footage on his laptop at his place. He learns Misaki's getting into a callgirl-centric fiasco with someone. Before he can question this dilemma further, someone calls Kainuma. He picks it up and learns it's someone from Taihei's hospital. Kojima tells Sunagawa he'll let Misaki work at Sunagawa's hostess club. Simultaneously, Fable eavesdrops on Kojima's conversation with Sunagawa from behind a wall. Then Fable and Misaki arrive to work the next day. Kainuma tells Misaki and Fable that Misaki's boss was taken to the hospital last night. Kainuma asks Misaki if she's been fooling around with dangerous people. He reveals that he knows someone from another workplace of hers who got hurt. Misaki leaves to get fresh air. Fable confronts Kainuma and demands he tell him everything he knows. Additionally, Fable knows Kainuma's been filming Misaki with hidden cameras. He wants Kainuma to hand over the footage so he can help Misaki. Later, Kojima picks Misaki up from one of her workplaces. Kojima gives Misaki an offer. If she helps him out by being a call girl and hostess, he'll only have her work for him and Sunagawa for 3 months. Kojima says he'll present Misaki with a contract to sign later so he doesn't have to worry about anything. He presents Misaki with the contract at his place and Misaki looks upset to sign it. Meanwhile, Yoko stumbles upon Fable crafting a gun barrel in the garage. Before we see Fable ask Yoko for help with something, we return to following Misaki and Kojima. Misaki goes with Kojima's faster deal and signs the contract. Meanwhile, Kojima drops Misaki off at her home and tells her to put on certain clothes for tomorrow's call girl day. Elsewhere, Takahashi visits Yoko. The latter gives the former a watch because she felt bad about their last date. Yoko bids Takahashi farewell minutes later and returns to Fable's side. She tells Fable that she gave Takahashi the GPS tracker watch. Fable says he'd normally kill his targets and leave, but he has to operate carefully since Misaki's involved in this dilemma. He doesn't want Misaki to discover the truth about his true line of work. Fable says he's developing gun rounds that'll knock out Kojima. He confirms how long it takes to make these special rounds. Fable telling Yoko why he wants to help Misaki. Yoko says she'd like to help Fable assist Misaki too and asks him what he can do. Meanwhile, Takahashi arrives at Kojima's place with food. Kojima tells Takahashi he and Sunagawa will be discussing a Misaki-related deal. Moreover, Kojima wants Takahashi to keep a close eye on Misaki. Meanwhile, Fable's busy working on ammo for his weapon. Suddenly, Misaki calls Fable and tells him she may not come to work tomorrow because she's ill. Misaki wants Fable to inform her boss about her dilemma. Fable brings up the handkerchief and job situation to Misaki. He thanks Misaki for helping him with those situations and says he'd like to show his appreciation to her. Fable says he'd like to take Misaki out to eat, but Misaki says he doesn't have to do that. Instead, Misaki suggests Fable draw a picture of herself. Fable says he'll bring the picture to her tomorrow, but Misaki says she won't be home until the next morning due to undisclosed reasons. Fable looks at his weapon and says she'll be home tomorrow. Then we cut away to Sunagawa and his hitman. The hitman gives Sunagawa a device that emits a mosquito tone. the hitman says it emits a sound only people 25 and above can hear. Since Kojima's young, he won't be able to hear anything. He wants Tsunagawa to signal him with the pen when he's finished discussing things with Kojima. The hitman promises to exterminate Kojima and Takahashi. Fable looks at his phone and notices Kojima, Takahashi, and others are near Misaki's place. Eventually Kojima picks up Misaki. Elsewhere Yoko suggests Fable deal with Kojima before he reaches Tsunagawa. Fable says it'd be easier to eliminate Kojima and Tsunagawa's groups the old-fashioned way. Meanwhile Fable's boss visits Takashi at the hospital. The boss is not happy he got Fable involved in some nefarious things. Eventually Tsunagawa and Kojima's group meet at their agreed location. Fable and Yoko arrive there too, but from a different location. Meanwhile boss tells Takashi to refer to him as Fable as well. Tsunagawa plans to chat with Kojima alone. Also Tsunagawa asks one of his men to have Misaki demonstrate her skills to him. Kojima grabs Misaki's bag and tells Tsunagawa he's bringing Takahashi to their meeting. He doesn't want someone to shoot him from behind when they finish negotiating. Fable arrives at a facility called Two-Story Ironworks. He tells Yoko this is where Kojima, Misaki, and Tsunagawa are located. Boss asks Takashi why he got Fable involved. Takashi tells boss that he's willing to deal with any punishment he's willing to hand to him. Next, Tsunagawa's henchmen bring Misaki to a room and plan to do nefarious things with her. Boss tells Takashi that he knows things have spiraled out of control since Takashi was hospitalized. Takashi begs boss to inform him about everything. Meanwhile, Tsunagawa and Kojima discuss Kojima's business plan. Kojima argues why he's in the right. Tsunagawa brings up Kojima's senior and questions Kojima about his senior's disappearance. Kojima says he doesn't know what Tsunagawa's talking about. Meanwhile, Tsunagawa's henchman tells Misaki to remove his clothes and perform an erotic deed to him. Misaki cries and refuses to perform the deed. This encourages Tsunagawa's ally to rip Misaki's clothes off. Tsunagawa's other allies discuss Misaki's situation. One of them is against the treatment Tsunagawa is putting her through. This confuses one of his allies, making him wonder why his coworker is a pure-hearted Yakuza member. Meanwhile, Tsunagawa's ally attempts to violate Misaki. He tells her only bad people prevail in this world. Fable arrives and knocks him out. Fable contacts Yoko, letting her know that he saved Misaki. Yoko reminds Fable that Misaki's not used to seeing violent things. She suggests Fable tell Misaki a joke or smile at her to calm her down. Fable imitates Jackal in front of Misaki, which frightens her more. He turns to Misaki and tells her the gun's a toy. Moreover, Fable says he'll be discussing with the three men outside. Fable depart. Tsunagawa tells Kojima that many people claim they saw Kojima leave his senior's residence. Kojima admits that he saw his senior and collected his money from him. Kojima smiles and Tsunagawa clicks his hitman's pen. Before the hitman shoots Kojima, someone attempts to shoot the hitman. Meanwhile, Takashi continues chatting with boss. Boss pulls out a knife and discusses its origins. Boss also shares how this knife relates to Boss's initial impression of Fable. Boss confirms he discovered Fable's natural talent and raised him to be an assassin. Ultimately, Boss doesn't want to get rid of Fable, nor does he want Takashi to involve Fable in more Yakuza business. Boss says he'll murder Takashi if he does. Boss departs. Next, Fable gets involved and plans to fight Tsunagawa's hire. Meanwhile, Takahashi and Kojima scramble on the ground searching for Misaki's bag. Kojima grabs a pistol and fires a shot at Tsunagawa. Fable tells the kickboxer to grab Misaki and flee the area with a car. Meanwhile, Fable plans to take care of things here. Fable ends the call and throws a smoke bomb in the area. Tsunagawa's hitman is impressed and wonders if he's dealing with Fable. If so, he wants to eliminate Fable. Fable heads downstairs and immobilizes the hitman. He shoots a few more rounds and harms Kojima. Fable walks past Tsunagawa's hitman and enters the area where Kojima and Takahashi are located. Fable scolds Takahashi for using a model gun. Fable grabs Kojima, exits the building, and shoots the device that's emitting the mosquito noise. The mosquito noise stops. The kickboxer flees with Misaki. Meanwhile, Fable rejoins Yoko and places Kojima in the trunk. Meanwhile, the kickboxer chats with Misaki. Misaki and the kickboxer wonder why the masked man saved them. This masked man was Fable. Moreover, Misaki is concerned about what will happen to her. The kickboxer says it'll depend on Kojima's fate. While that's happening, Sunagawa's hitman and hire inform Sunagawa about Fable and wonder what he plans to do with Kojima. Meanwhile, Fable returns home and Kojima sees Fable unmasked. Meanwhile, the kickboxer drops Misaki off somewhere and hands her his phone number. He tells Misaki to call him if she runs into trouble. At the same time Sunagawa investigates the area, he looks at the toy bullet Fable used to harm everyone. Sunagawa reflects on the intel his hitman and other allies told him about. He wonders if Hiroshi or Takashi ordered Fable to interrupt his and Kojima's meeting. Sunagawa tells Takahashi and the other men to leave the area.